你准备平安，今日是十十一嘅初六，十一盘头夕嘅主日，时间世纪也见海嚟到November，咱两千二十二年从南国嘅特别结束咯。你准备，咱教会已经对新嘅开始有 onsite 嘅 service，虽然咱结束有 online 及这个 live stream 嘅聚会，但是咱实在真鼓励你，你那辛苦实在啦，完全我望你有通嚟到。啊，门徒训练中心杀鸽嚟敬拜我哋上帝。虽然咧有当 online 啊 live stream 嚟敬拜上帝，但是欠一个物件，欠什么物件咧？呢个叫 community， 叫做社区嘅生活。咱做以后，咱有当搞，系咧只俾杀鸽就一个杀鸽简单嘅时间，杀鸽嚟沟通，杀鸽嚟 fellowship， 这个是崇拜。你哋出来完全准备到嘅所在，所以你啦，主啦，完全你啦，心内感觉真平安，那是就真扎果嚟你嗬，现在就嚟嚟到你哋门徒训练中心中嚟撒吉嚟侍奉上帝，撒吉嚟敬拜上帝，撒吉嚟唱歌，撒吉嚟弹琴。咁嗰阵咪将自己就会即系祈祷交到上帝超嘅中间。第八关感谢你何君嚟到十一嘅头一嘅礼拜，时间就系嘅廿斤。两千二十二年特别结束了，从两个月的时间，感谢上帝对世界开始，你的姊妹已经开始慢慢来到教会，大家来敬拜上帝，为着你的姊妹的这款人的需要，跟结束有这款的online worship， 甚至 live stream 的 worship， 但是求主帮助跟这个是帮助这款无法来的姊妹，你的姊妹你那有通来跟实在求上帝感动，好管大家人踊跃来参加聚会，唔那是撒开来敬拜上帝，撒开来领受上帝教导，第一重要有一个团契生活。好管仔啊，这个是个家，这个属灵嘅家。我就买张杂志啊，嗰个 online 嘅 worship， 嗰个 onsite 嘅 service， 嗰个 live stream 嘅 worship， 完全教导主啲朝堂，管理灵嘅帮助官，好管好嚟当心合意，用心灵用诚实嚟敬拜上帝，感谢上帝。听我的感恩，奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名， Amen， Amen。你为世界接落音乐来，我来呢就。
Holy, holy, merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. The King of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from, oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide, the ransom for my life, oh, he is my song. 'Cause you are good, you're good. You are good, you're good. Let the King of my heart be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the waves, oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days, oh, he is my song. 'Cause you are good, you're good. Ooh, you are good, you're good. Ooh, you are good, you're good. Ooh, you are good.
弟兄姊妹平安，咱是个人呢，陪伴咱的心灵，耶稣主的饼及主的杯，请得按圣经话。在哥林多前书第十一章廿三到廿八节，圣经讲：我当日传道恁的，原是对主所领受，所以主耶稣并非一暗夺起饼来，祝谢了就劈开讲：这是我的身躯，为你放杀，你就按呢行，为的是纪念我。饭后也同款夺起杯来讲：这个杯是用我血所立的新约，你特别啉的时就按呢行，为的是纪念我。你特别食这个饼、啉这个杯，是表明主的死直等到伊来。所以无论什么人，若无按你食主的饼、啉主的杯，就是干犯主的心及主的血咯。所以人应该家己省察，然后食这个饼、啉这个杯。这段圣经是保罗写给教会，教导咱照着耶稣主的饼及主的杯。主耶稣并非一暗将这个圣餐来设立。伊将这个饼劈开，将伊葡萄汁倒出。主耶稣讲：这个饼是代表我的身躯，这个葡萄汁是代表我的血。这个饼劈开，这个葡萄汁倒出，是代表主耶稣的十字架为咱的罪，将身躯劈开，将宝血流出来洗净咱的罪。但系圣经及咱讲，人应当家己省察，然后食这个饼，啉这个杯。所以你做圣餐的人，需要家己好来祈祷，好来省察家己，避免这个心来耶稣做咱的饼及主的杯。咱时刻安静地坐位里面，好来祈祷，求上帝灵来省察咱，避免咱的心来耶稣主今日好咱的饼及主的杯。咱大家来唱一个圣诗，比如咱的心灵耶稣做的饼及做的杯，咱唱咱的圣餐的歌，省察家己。咱大家来唱。
当我们走到神的面前，默默审查自己，回想以往的年日里，蒙了多少恩典。主啊，主啊，我亏欠了你，我真亏欠了你。求主赦免我罪过，怜悯我们。有多少时间奉献给你，专为子子而求？再多少思想亏欠了主，养生的担忧。主啊，主啊，我亏欠了你，我真亏欠了你。求主赦免我罪过，怜悯我们。如今我愿意悔改谦卑，求主进入我心中，愿将一生献给 感谢你，我也感谢你，因为你已赦免我们，拯救我们。
那这个人也是主的饼和主的杯， put the bread and the cup together。我们再做一个感恩的祈祷。天父，我们感谢你，你听我们，将你独生子主耶稣赐给我们，为我们的罪钉在十字架里面，将你的身躯劈开，主将宝血流出，来洗净我们的罪，医治我们一切的亏欠，让我们在做上帝你的儿女，今天有通领受你的饼入你的杯，让你的生命提起我们已经在我们的里面。保罗说，现在活着不再是我，乃是基督在我里面活着，让我们因为主的生命的原因，让我们一生为主来活。弟兄们，感谢你，祝福今天在你的头前领受饼和杯的姊妹，愿我们每一个人，我们的身躯，我的灵，我的魂，拢都蒙主你家己的保守，完全无通指跌，直到主耶稣第二摆对天顶过来。愿上帝祝福你，赐恩给你，祈祷奉告主耶稣基督的圣名， Amen。 愿上帝祝福你，兄弟姊妹， Amen。兄弟姐妹平安，
Peace be to you, brothers and sisters。
但各位师兄，公义的上帝，伟大的神，奇妙的救恩，这个系列的信息。
Let's continue in our series, God's Righteousness, a Great God, Amazing Salvation。
今天的师兄是罗马书第十三章一到第七节。
And our text for today can be found in Romans chapter 13 verses 1 to 7。
基督徒应该顺服掌管的人吗？
Should Christians submit to authority? In Romans chapter 12 verses 9 to 21, we talked about how we as Christians can become living sacrifices for the Lord in society. Romans chapter 13 is an extension of this topic. But our focus here is whether we as Christians should submit to authority or not. This is a very big challenge. We recently here in the Philippines just elected our new president. I don't know if you voted for him or not. Then let me ask you, should you submit to him or not? Or do we openly oppose this person? Today we will be talking in general terms. Because Paul said, let everyone be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except that which God has established. I'm sure that in your heart you have this question. What if this person who's in authority is a very evil, a very wicked person? Or do we have an evil, corrupt government? Should we continue submitting to that authority? But if you read Romans chapter 13, there's no specifics about this. But please remember, the Roman Empire and those who were in authority during that time were not people who revered God. The things that we are facing today, the situation that we are in today, is the same that Paul was in the past. Today, allow me to explain these 7 verses to you. And I'd like to bring out 3 applications for us to be able to apply. Today, we can call our sermon as 1, 2, 3. One example, 2 reasons, and 3 applications. First, let me explain the two reasons.
能信服制上有权柄的人的原因。
The reasons why we need to submit to authority.
各做各讲一个例子。
And I'd like to give an example.
在结束的时候，我提出三观的应用。
And in conclusion, I would like to give three applications.
Okay, 来来看头像。
Let's look at the first one.
信服掌管者的原因是在哪里？
Where lies the reasons for us to submit to authority?
这段圣经讲到两个原因。
Here in these seven verses, it talks about two reasons. The first,
because
authorities were established by God.
Look at
Romans
13 verses 1 to 2.
Let everyone be subject to the governing authorities, for this, there is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist have been established by God. Take note of the word here, established.
So, 抗拒掌管的，就是抗拒上帝命令，抗拒的，的确自取刑罚。
Consequently, who rebels against the authority is rebelling against what God has instituted, and those who will do so will bring judgment on themselves.
NIV 将这个命令换成 established。
Here in NIV, the word established was used.
King James appointed William.
But if you are to look at the King James Version, the word used there was appointed. So Paul was saying that those who are in the authorities were people appointed by God. So that's why we have to submit to their authority. And what do we call this?
Creation order.
This is what we call creation order. When God created this world, there are a lot of creation orders God has given us. That's why their world will not be chaotic. In the household, we have the wives submitting to the husband. Those who are servants, they submit to their masters. And if we follow the hierarchy, then there will be no confusion and chaos in that household. The same way for society, we submit to those who are in authority. Our president, our government, even our police. That's for us to create order in society. We don't have to look far from this. Today, as we join this worship service, we have this MC. The church has appointed him and given him the authority to MC this service. When he asks us to rise, all of us stand up. When he asks us to sit, all of us sit down. When we are called to praise and to sing and praise the Lord, all of us do so. We obey the things that he placed in order. But if the opposite, if we refuse to submit, when he asks us to stand, we still remain seated. When he asks us to sit, we stand up. When he asks us to sing, we don't want to sing. It's only when the pastor is preaching that you start singing. Then it'll create an atmosphere of chaos and confusion in this worship service. That's why there's a reason why the people in the church, the congregation, follows the order of the MC. It'll make the job of the MC and make him more effective in being the master of the ceremonies of our worship service. The same way, we submit to those who are in authority. Because those who are in authority were appointed by God. We submit to the governing authorities for them to effectively fulfill their God-given mission. So you probably would ask this second question. Then what is this God-given mission God has given for those people in authority? Look at 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 13 and 14.
得信服冷热之的遮道，还是在上的冠王，还是冠王所委派，注意发恶想善的神仔。
Submit yourselves to the,、for the Lord's sake to every human authority, whether the emperor as the supreme authority or to governors who are sent by him to punish those who do wrong and to commend those who do right. There are four Chinese characters here we need to take note of. To punish those who are wrong and to commend those who do right. This is the mandate, this is the mission God has given to those who are in authority. God has given them this authority. They need to punish those who do wrong. And we have to commend and encourage those who do right.
So authority 有保护我们的作用，你知道不？
So that's why those who are in authority have this responsibility to protect us.
Even though 这关不是真好的政权啊，政府啊。
Even if there, we don't see that this government is a very effect, is very good.
有通保护我们啊。
They still can protect us.
因为上帝使用伊来管理对照的国家。
Because God will use them to govern.The things and the affairs of this world.
So
that's why Paul said,
So, consequently,
whoever rebels against the authority is rebelling against what God has instituted, and those who will do so will bring judgment on themselves. You now will raise another question. What if?The government that we have is the opposite. What if they punish those who do right and commend those who do wrong? If you do something right, they punish you. But if you do something wrong, they reward you for it. Should we as Christians submit to such kind of authority? Let me go on and say, Paul had never raised any of these specifics in Romans chapter
13.
Because Paul here was speaking in general terms. Paul was just simply saying that we should submit to those who are in authority. But when we talk about the application, I will bring up some principles for us to be facing our specific situations. Second, the second reason why we should submit to authority because those who are in authority are God's servants. Look at verses 3-5. For rulers hold no terror for those who do right, but for those who do wrong. Do you want to be free from fear of the one who in authority? Then do what is right and you will be commended.For the one in authority is God's servant for you, for your good. If you do wrong, be afraid, for rulers do not bear the sword for no reason. They are God's servant, agents of wrath to bring punishment on the wrongdoer. Therefore, it is necessary to submit to the authorities, not only because of possible punishment, but also as a matter of conscience.
Okay.
If you take note that Paul twice,mentioned this phrase. These people in authority are God's servants. And you say, is this true? How can we say that those are ruling, the ruling Communist Party in China are God's servants? They are atheistic. They don't believe in God. In fact, they oppose religion.How can they be God's servants? They are. In 1979, when China became a communist, even though they have no faith, but God used this government to fulfill this amazing work of God.Because we often have this impression that God will only use people who revere Him. Those who oppose Him, God will not use. That's not true.
全对, 无论是人, 无论是动物,
Everything in this world, whether humans or animals, are God's servants.
Something nature, 自然界都是上帝仆人.
Even the nature are part of God's servanthood.
希伯来说说,荒黑是上帝仆人.
And even in the book of Hebrews said that the wind and the fire and the light, all of them obey God's command.
你看Jonah的故事.
Look at the story of Jonah.
大鱼将Jonah吞下去.
This big fish swallowed up Jonah.
大鱼是上帝仆人.
And that big fish is God's servant.
你记得这个贪财的先知叫Balaam.
If you remember this corrupt prophet named Balaam.
这个Balaam的一只donkey啊，开嘴责备自己的主人啊.
And the donkey spoke and rebuked Balaam.
这只donkey是上帝仆人.
And that donkey was used by God. It was God's servant.
请问上帝有通用共产来完成上帝工作吗？
So let me ask you, can God use the Communist Party or the Communist government of China to fulfill his work?
Yes.
The answer is yes.
1949年共产的时候.
So it was correct. My correction, it was 1949 when China became communist.
基督徒啊，包括天主教都只有五十万人啦，五十万人。
The Chinese Christians, including the
Catholics,
were about 500,000 people.
但是你知啊，五十年以后，五十年以后。
But 50 years later,
当共产管理中国五十年以后。
After the Communist Party had been in power for 50 years,
当中国这个门 open 的时候，
when China started to open its doors,
全世界都惊着。
Everybody in this world were shocked and were surprised.
100 million.
Because during that time, Chinese believers numbered in 100 million.
1,000 million.
And God is truly amazing. And God used the Communist Party to fulfill his own work.
因为 through the persecution, 那信仰更加有根基的主在里面。
Maybe because of the persecutions that they faced, they were deeply rooted.
所以保罗提醒我们。
That's why Paul reminded us.
人最上帝的仆人，人最上帝家里的顺服在上有权柄的人。
God, he said that we who are Christians should submit to those who are in authority.
我们在这里要注意。
And there are two things we need to take note of.
第一。
The first,
我们需要行先。
We need to do what is right.
为什么呢?
Why?
你看13节。
Look at verse 13.
他说最乖的关系不是叫行先的行下啦，而是叫最歹的行下啦。你管你无行下奖管的人嘛，真简单啦，你要行先，创好大志，他就得他的称赞咯。
For rulers hold no terror for those who do right, but those who do wrong. Do you want to be free from fear of the one in authority? Then do what is right and you will be commended. In a very normal situation, those who are in authority should bring fear to those who would like to do wrong. If you're not doing anything wrong, if you did not break any law, if you see a policeman, would you fear? You know, when I was a child, I have this very special experience. That was in 1978. There were a lot of illegal immigrants from mainland China into Hong Kong. That's why the government of Hong Kong made this ordinance. All of the Hong Kong citizens need to bring their Hong Kong ID with them whenever they go out. Because the police will conduct random check to check your IDs.
Make sure
that you are not an illegal immigrant. I remember one time. I went out. I forgot to bring my ID. As I was walking down the street, I saw several policemen randomly checking the IDs of people on the street. I checked my wallet and I realized that I forgot to bring my ID. And my heart started beating so fast. I cannot turn back and run. Because they will run after me.
慢慢走，慢慢走，慢慢走。
So I slowly approached them.
你等我经过几个police station啊。
But as I walked past them, my heart was about to burst.
为什么呀?
Why?
因为我没记得 Hong Kong ID.
Because I forgot my Hong Kong ID.
我留多呢?
If I had brought my ID,
我想问他,
what have I to fear?
你来被check,可以看过?
If they want to check, I can just simply show them.
所以保罗讲什么呢?
So what is Paul saying
here?
If you're obeying the law, if you're doing what is right, then what have you to fear? He said, may the Lord
help us.
But if you do evil, then you have to fear. Because those who have authority, they have a sword, they have the authority over you. Second, we need to submit. Look at verse
5.
Therefore, it is necessary to submit to the authorities not only because of possible punishment, but also as a matter of conscience. Paul said we need to submit to those who are in authority. Not because of fear. But more importantly, because of our conscience.
这是什么意思呢?
What does this mean?
这个良心是讲基督徒的良心, 不是世界人的良心啊。
Here Paul was referring to the conscience of a Christian.
是这个良心已经让心灵哦, 重新就是stimulate,刺激起,活起来的良心啊。
We're talking about this conscience that has been stimulated and renewed by the Holy Spirit.
因为上帝都在你的心里面。
Because we have the Word of God in our heart.
圣灵感动你的心里面。
The Holy Spirit is moving in our heart.
所以我们就要追上帝的家里天国的国民啊。
So we as children of God, citizens of heaven,
我们需要追对着这个真正的国民。
We have to become good citizens here on earth.
我们需要尽我们的责任。
We need to do our responsibilities and duties as citizens.
为了什么?
Why do we need to do so?
为了让上帝给你美好的见证。
So that we can establish a good testimony for the Lord. So that in our conscience, we will not be lacking to the Lord. These are two reasons why we need to submit to authority. Second, let's talk about an example. Let me give you an example rather of why we need to submit to authority. Look at verses 6 and 7. This is also why you pay taxes, for the authorities are God's servants who give their full time to governing. Give to everyone what you owe them. If you owe taxes, pay taxes. If revenue, then revenue. If respect, then respect. If honor, then honor. Here, Paul clearly used the example of paying taxes
to
us. As citizens of God, as children of God, we need to submit to those who are in authority. Very simply, we pay our taxes. Because this is our responsibility and that's our duty as a citizen. In today's society, it's not easy for us to evade taxes. Because all of the nations here place much importance in tax collection. That's why they are very careful. They investigate those people who are not paying their taxes. But how about 2,000 years ago? It's quite easier. It's more easier for them not to pay their taxes. Everything is recorded in the computer by the BIR. Probably you say if I buy things there's no receipt.
So
you think that if I don't pay my taxes, if I cheat on my taxes, it's easier. But Paul said, for if you owe taxes, pay taxes. Why? Because those who are in authority, the government, are God's servants. God has appointed them to look over such affairs. That's why we need to pay our taxes. When Christ was here on earth, somebody once asked him, We need to pay taxes to the Roman Empire. We need to pay taxes to Caesar. You know, this problem, this question is a temptation problem. Because during that time, the whole Israel, the Jewish people were under the Roman Empire. You pay taxes. That means you recognize the Roman government. It means that they're not patriotic. They don't love their country. But if you don't pay your taxes,
then
the Roman Empire, the Roman government will be angry with you. They will call you a rebel.
Yes or no,
so whether Jesus answered yes or no, people will find fault in his answer. But our Lord Jesus Christ is full of wisdom. He didn't say yes, he didn't say no. He only asked another question in return. Give me a coin. Look at Luke chapter 20, verses 24-25. Show me a denarius. Whose image and inscription are on it? Caesar's, they replied. And he said to them, Give back to Caesar what is Caesar's and to God what is God's. Jesus said, give me a denarius, give me a coin. Whose image and inscription are on it? They said, Caesar. If you take out your money, you find a face, face or an image that's printed there. If you have the old Hong Kong dollar,
a Queen Elizabeth came in, Queen Elizabeth in
the hall. You would find that on the coin, there's this image and inscription of the late Queen Elizabeth. And he asked whose image is on it.
Caesar.
And they said, it's Caesar's. Since Caesar's image is there, then give back to Caesar what is Caesar's. But he's not yet done. He added one more thing. Then give to God what is God's. What does he mean here? And what things here have the image of God? Human beings. Because in Genesis 1:27, God created all of us, all the human, all mankind according to his own image. So we have the image of God. We were created according to the image of God. And we belong to God. Give to God the money and give ourselves to God. Here God was trying to remind the Pharisees, don't try to tempt God or to test God, because you belong to God. You should be keeping God's words, not here to test your God. The same way, we who are citizens of God, we have to do our responsibilities as citizens. Don't find an excuse or an alibi for yourself. Because for us to find an excuse not to obey God. The third, there are three applications I'd like to share with you. The first, please remember, we have to submit to authority in love. In a very normal situation, we need to submit to those who are in authority. Because authority in itself is not evil, nor is it bad. If authority is good. Because authority comes from God. It's only when the authority is being abused. Only then can we call the authority as bad. So we need to thank God that we have a government. We need to to thank God for a policeman. If there are no people watching over the order, the peace and order of society, I guarantee you, we will be living in an atmosphere of fear. Remember the time in Indonesia when they were against the Chinese? It seems like they had no government. You would see photographs of the atrocities being committed and you would feel very bad. You would say to yourself, are these acts committed by human beings or not?
有官兵是好诶,
so authority is good.
有政府来掌管来维持秩序是好诶,
you have the government govern and look after the affairs of this country is good.
但是咱全部的源头不是政府是上帝,
but we submit not because of the authority of this government but because of God.
咱是顺服上帝来顺服在上有官兵的人,
we are submitting to them because we are submitting to God. You know, in the church, we need to learn how to submit to authority. Church is not a democratic place. We place much emphasis on democracy.
But of course,
the church is not a dictatorship. It's not an authoritarian a place. Here is a place of righteousness and of justice. Because this church is a place where God governs. You know, during World War II, the Nazi government of Germany during that time had this very evil command. If you know that your neighbor is a Jew, you need to bring them out and to bring them to the authority. If not, then you will be committing a crime. Let me ask you, as Christians, should we obey such a command? Of course not. Then if we don't obey such command, aren't we in defiance of the law of the Bible? No, we're not. Why? Because there's a higher command that trumps this command. Look at Romans 13, verse
10.
Love does no harm to a neighbor, therefore love is the fulfillment of the law. What is higher than the law? Love is greater than the law. When we submit to authority, we do so in love. We do submit to authority because of love. And because of love, we obey the ordinances of this country. So that will create order in this society. That people will not be harmed. So during World War II, there are people who truly love the Lord. There are a lot of beautiful stories being told about what they did. How they have saved the lives of so many Jews.
Yes.
So they have defied the laws of the Nazi government. And because of this, some of the non-Jews were even brought to the concentration camp. But we are truly deeply moved by these stories. In fact, some of these stories have been made into movies. I don't know if you have watched these two movies.
Missed hiding place.
The first is the hiding place. The second is the Schindler's List. And these two movies talks about how people have hidden and saved the Jews. So may the Lord help us.
Application.
The first application. Please remember. Love is great, bigger than being obedient to the Lord. We obey the law because of love. If we do so without love, then we are not truly obeying. The second application. We have to help the authority in love. Let me ask you. What is the mandate for the government? Look at, remember the four Chinese characters? To punish those who do wrong and to commend those who do right. This is the mandate God had given to all of those who are in authority. But I'd like you to think and ponder this question. Who is the one who decides what is good and what is not good? Please remember. What is right and what is wrong is not being decided by men. Nor is it determined by the crowd or by the majority of what is right and what is wrong. I'm saying that democracy is good. Christianity is not opposed to democracy. But democracy does not represent the truth. So that there are certain things here in the church. That's why we need to vote on it. But with regards to truth, we should not put it into votation. Because to decide what is right and what is wrong should not be decided by people because it's already very clear in the Bible. So that's why we cannot use votation to determine what is right and what is wrong. There's no need. Because we can find what is right and what is wrong according to the truths laid out by the Bible. When those who are in authority had turned their backs against the truth, what is the responsibility of the church? Church has the authority, has the right to let the government know what is right and what is wrong. One of the earlier church fathers said, the church is society's conscience. The church has this responsibility to tell the world what is right and what is wrong. We submit to those who are in authority. But we need to help the authority in love. For example, for us as wives, shouldn't we as wives submit to our husbands? What if your husband likes to drink? And he often get drunk. And he would become disorderly in his conduct when he becomes drunk. When your husband requires you to bring him more drinks, more alcoholic drinks, what do we do as a wife? Do we obey him? We bring more wine or more alcoholic beverages home for him to drink so that he'll drink to death. This is not submitting. This is submitting not out of love. Because this kind of submission does not help your husband to become a better husband. The same way. For us who are leaders here in church, regardless of your position, whether you're the pastor, you're an elder, you're a deacon, if we did something wrong, our congregation has the responsibility to remind us. Not to rebuke us, but to remind us. Why? Because we want our church leaders to become better leaders. To become better pastors, to become better elders, to become better deacons. Last one. The last application. All those who are in authority need to wake up to reality. For those who are in authority amongst us, if you have a part in the Philippine government, or you have an authority inside a church, or you have an authority in your company, or you are a person of authority in your own household, all of us need to wake up to reality. Because authority is being established by God. Authority is not God. Authorities were established government. By God. The government was established by God. But the government is not God. So those who are in authority, they need to understand one thing. The foundation and the source of our authority is God. God is the one who gave us authority. Please remember, the same way God can take away that authority from us. So that's why everyone who's in authority needs to know this. Remember when we talk about the book of Daniel? In chapter 2 of the book of Daniel, wasn't it that King Nebuchadnezzar had this dream? In that dream, he had this dream of a huge image. The head is made out of gold. And the chest is silver. And the waist here is made of bronze. And the legs were made out of steel, of iron. While the feet were made out of half clay and half steel. And how did Daniel explain this? Here, Daniel said these are four empires. The head is the Babylonian empire. And the chest is the Medo-Persian empire. And the waist is the Greek Empire. While the legs are the Roman Empire. And all of these were prepared and arranged by God. But Daniel said, praise be to the name of God forever and ever. Wisdom and power are His. He changes times and seasons. He deposes kings and raises up others. He gives wisdom to the wise and knowledge to the discerning. He establishes and raises kings. And He also is the one who deposes them. This is a very important reminder to everyone who has authority. Don't think that you're good, that's why you're in a position. Just one word from God. Just one action. Everyone who's there on the throne would be removed from the throne. Let me ask you. Which kingdom, which government, which king would be there forever? There's none. Only one authority is forever and ever. That's the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because He's the King of Kings, He's the Lord of Lords. So that's why when we submit to those who are in authority, because we believe in one thing. We believe that authority was given by God. We submit to authority because we submit to the one who gives authority. We humble ourselves. So we know. God is the one who gives, God is the one who takes away. There's nothing in me that I can be proud of or be boastful of. I need to do my responsibility to the best that I can as a leader.
最怕的怀疑最好的少数意
To punish those who do evil and do wrong and to commend those and reward those who do right.
Full stop.
Full stop.
叫主帮衬
May the Lord help us.
这是保罗教导人在社会里面就为上帝最活着
This is how Paul is teaching us to become living sacrifices in society.
特别讲到人就顺服在社会中间顶面有权柄的人
And especially tackling the topic, the very important topic ofSubmitting to those who are in authority over us in here in this world. May the Lord be with us. We obey everything, we submit to everything for the Lord's sake.
Let's pray.
Let's pray. Lord, we thank you. Through Romans chapter 13, we are being reminded once more of our need to submit to authority. This is such a big challenge. Because there's no truly righteous, no truly just government here in this world. As Christians, as citizens of both heaven and this world, how do we face these challenges? Maybe through today's message, that we are reminded, we do everything because of love. Because love trumps and it's over all the laws.
Under the 天的下骹
and the law should be under love.
人顺服在个天的里面
We submit and we obey out of love.
帮助你的教会
May you help the church.
无论是这个在教会里面、在社会里面、在公司里面，好学习做这个掌管的人、管柄的人
For those who are in authority, whether in the church, in our companies, in our household, that we will learn to be in authority in the wise way.
我够明白这个。掌管的人，伊的 mandate， 伊的说明是首先发恶。
That we will know that our mandate as a leader, as a person of authority, that it is to punish those who are doing wrong and to commend those who are doing right.
上帝有关的使命。
Because this is the mandate, Lord, you have given us.
感谢上帝。
Thank you, Lord.
听我的祈祷。
Hear us in our prayer.
用我主耶稣基督的圣名。
And this is our prayer in the most holy name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. 你这边礼拜呢，来说讲罗马书十三章的不。
Let's look at Romans chapter 8, 13, verse 8 next week. Until verse 21. Let's look at another message. Let's meet again next week. God bless.